very foundation of democracy. Why are we not talking about it anymore? Where's the evidence? Why are people not being impeached, arrested, tried? Why not?
Patience, I guess. I don't know. Listen, we've said this from the start. This story has never had legs. It's never had any real evidence behind it. There was a dossier created for the Democrats to, you know, come up with this narrative. Hillary Clinton basically invented the narrative. It's all ridiculous.
But isn't it funny how it just comes back around? All the stuff they projected onto Donald Trump, it turns out that they're guilty tenfold of treasonous activities.
The best lies are rooted in some truth. And maybe the truth of the Russia lie is that it wasn't the Republicans. Maybe it was the Democrats. Who knows?
Well, we shall see. Podesta and all these other knuckleheads were in the same boat with the email scandal, and they got their stuff hacked.
By the way, Russ, you've changed your password from 1234 because you saw with Podesta that that's the way to get hacked, right?
Yeah, well, he's a dummy answering online sex ads and putting his password out there, logging in through his Gmail account. Real dummy.
Now, I just picture Spaceballs going, the password is 12345. That's what I picture.
Can I give a conspiracy theory since we do this every once in a while?
Why not? Why not? That's what we do.
So you've seen that most of the JFK files are going to be declassified in the coming
Yes! Roger Stone, of all people, announcing that, along with a Donald Trump tweet, that the remaining classified JFK files are going to be released in the near future. And I know that Roger Stone, former guest friend of the show, is salivating to see if LBJ has any sort of connection, as he says in his book. Very interesting stuff to see what happens, Russ.
Oh, I can't wait to see what happens there. I think that's a little outlandish, and I said so at the time when Roger Stone was actually in Brooklyn pushing that idea. But what's not so outlandish is Lee Harvey Oswald spent some time in Russia, spoke Russian, and had lots of contact with the KGB. So in the context of this whole Russia collusion thing, I'm dying to see what classified information gets declassified having to do with Lee Harvey Oswald and the Russians in the JFK assassination.
Very interesting stuff. I'm interested to see what role the mafia had, if any, in this whole thing. By the way, there is no such thing as mafia. I'm just saying.
Yeah, come on, Gene. You're making us look bad here.
But they're going to say that. They're going to say mafia, and they're going to have to refute that allegation. There's no such thing. You know what?
I don't doubt that the mafia had something to do with taking out Ruby, but they were probably just hired stooges to do that.
Hey, so let me ask you this, though. I got to ask you this, because you brought up distraction, and you brought up the tennis ball machine theory of crisis politics. Is the release of these tapes part of a Trump tennis ball machine practice of putting something else out there to distract from, I don't know, a tax reform deal that may be in trouble or something like that? Could that be a possibility?
Trump is brilliant. He knows how to play the media. He plays them like a fiddle. So what you're saying could have some credence. I don't know. My gut is telling me it has something either to do with Russia or on the far crazy side of the conspiracy theories. Maybe Lyndon Johnson is implicated in some way or shape or form, and it makes the Democrats look bad too. I don't know. As far as the tax reform, I think that, you know, this is a winner. The economy is doing fantastic right now, Gene. The Dow is up over 23,000. Unemployment's the lowest it's been in years. And the media is nowhere to be found on these stories, which I think is telling in and of itself, especially in the context of the Project Veritas New York Times editor.
Oh, absolutely. Listen, over 50 new record highs for the Dow this year alone. Unemployment, as you said, has been dropping. You've seen border crossings at an all-time low. You know, if you believe, you know, the numbers and everything that we learned back in June. Gorsuch is on the bench with probably more conservative justices to come. It is a good time to be a conservative, I think. There's some downsides, but this is so far so good.
He did not recertify the Iran nuclear deal. That doesn't mean we're out of the deal. We're still in the deal. He just didn't certify them period. He pulled the funding going to Obamacare subsidies, which was found to be unconstitutional by a federal court, which I find astonishing that he's getting beat up for this, that the Democratic president prior to him, which they seem to believe in the courts for everything except when it goes against them, was doing something unconstitutional. Congress appropriates funds. All appropriations bills start in the House of Representatives. So something that was never appropriated was being paid, and Donald Trump put a stop to it via executive order. Just basically reversing an executive order that President Obama put into place. So we're winning. We're winning on healthcare. We're winning on tax reform. The economy's booming. Our foreign policy is awesome. I thought, you know, by standing up to Kim Jong-un over there, or Ill, whatever, whichever one is in power nowadays, was going to cause World War III. What happened? He seems to be backing down somewhat, if you know what I mean.
Absolutely. Listen, there's a whole bunch of people with, you know, egg on their face right now. Remember all the predictions on election night about how the economy was going to lose 10%? And we have the strongest, you know, Dow with record highs 50 times this year. I mean, everyone has been wrong at this point. And
they've been wrong, Gene. And if I wasn't paying attention, I would have missed it because it only hit the news for like 10 seconds. We beat ISIS, basically. Their capital of Raqqa in Syria was toppled. Their whole caliphate is in shambles. We're winning. Where is that in the news?
Absolutely, and I just want to say, not without speed bumps, we need to know what happened in Niger, and, you know, we need to get Obamacare fully repealed, and that was a big black eye. But yes, I think that we are on an upward trajectory. I know that there are lots of people out there that are hating on it, but I think we're there, Russ. I think we've seen a good foundation year one compared to a President Reagan year one, which is absolutely atrocious. You know, he's really known more for his second term than he is his first term. My goodness, Trump, I think, is doing a pretty darn good job, especially first year, especially with the monumental resistance and opposition he has faced, without having a full staff in his executive branch, without having appointees being approved by the Senate. You gotta say, through it all, he's done well, but you'd never know it from what the media is saying. Absolutely right. Russ, we're running out of show. I want to thank everybody for listening to the show. I want to thank Alireza Jafarzadeh for coming on the show. Final thought time, Mr. Gallo.
Listen, there's some grumblings going on. This is fresh out of the sun from our pals over at the United Kingdom. North Korea has biological weapons. We've heard this before with other countries. I'm not saying we should sleep on this. I'm just saying we need to verify, make sure 100%. Because whether we go to take this guy out and he has chemical weapons or not, biological weapons or not, it's going to be a problem either way. Let's just really look into it before we commit young American lives.
Absolutely. Final thought for me, I'm going to keep it national. We just saw last week the debate, if you want to call it that, between Bernie Sanders and Ted Cruz on tax reform. And if there was ever a time when you can say that one side owned the other side, it was Ted Cruz. He was so prepared. He reminded us all why we, at least I, originally wanted him to be president. He was commanding, he was factual, and he tore apart the left in the form of Bernie Sanders. I thought it was a phenomenal job. And listen, the momentum here needs to keep going for 2018. That's all I got to say. Rush is sniggering over there. Go ahead.
Gene, is Ted Cruz sweating it out because this JFK stuff's coming out? Didn't President Trump accuse Ted Cruz's father of having some kind of
connection? Oh, I don't even want to go there. Oh, man, I didn't even want to go there. You're right. Oh, okay. Hold your breath. Hold your breath on that.
It's going to be a great week. I can't wait till next week.
Oh, it's going to be so much fun. And until next week, folks, it's time to shut this thing down. Russ, you ready to shut it down?
Gene, shut this mofo down.
All right, folks, from the People's Republic of New York, Gene and Russ behind enemy lines. We are out of here. Good night, folks.
Our position's been compromised. It's time to roll out. Report for debriefing at www.behindenemylinesradio.us and look for regular communications via Facebook and Twitter at BEL_radio. You are the resistance. Behind Enemy Lines. A Rock Radio production. Copyright 2016. Back in 7 days. Out.